This is the default date picker. And this is the custom one. I used the date entry widget from the TK Calendar Python library to create this entry with the calendar pop-up. To install the library, just run on your command line pip install TK Calendar. Then we will prepare the application window. We import TK and label from tkinter. We define the background color of our window. We create the main window of the application. We define the title, the size and position of the window. We set the previously defined background color. Before creating the label, we can specify a custom font. We also define the color of the text of our future label. Now we will create the label that will be at the left of our date picker. In our case, it will simply say select a date. Now we will add our label to the display of the window using the pack method by specifying an horizontal padding and the side with the left value. To run and display the application's window, we will call the main loop method. When we run the code, we can see the label on the newly created window. In the next step, we will add the actual date entry. The date picker is actually the date entry widget from the TK calendar. This is why we will start by importing the date entry widget from the TK calendar module. Create the actual date entry, aka date picker. We will simply create an object of date entry class. After that, we add the widget to the main window using the pack method. When we run the app and click on the button at rightmost side, we deploy a calendar or date picker. We can select any date, month, or year. Concerning the customization, in fact, we have two different widgets that we can customize from the same object. The first widget is the date entry itself. We can change these four values: the background color of the entry, the feed background property, the foreground color, aka the text color, the foreground property, the background color of the button that opens up the calendar dialog, the background color property, the color of the arrow on that button, the arrow color property. The date entry widget inherits the properties of the TTK entry widget. This is why we start by importing TTK. We define our four colors. To customize a TTK widget, we create a style instance. We use it first to apply the clamp theme. We do so to ensure that all the customizations that we define will actually apply on the entry widget. Now we create and configure a new custom style. We call it DE and it inherits from date entry style created for and used by the date entry widget. We set the background color of the date entry. We set the color of the text on the date entry. We set the background color of the arrow button and we set the color of that arrow itself. To apply the style, we simply set the style property of the widget to de.dateEntry created style. As you can see, the four colors changed, but the calendar colors didn't yet. In the next step, we will see how to change them. We will customize the calendar widget while creating the date entry. We will simply set properties inside the date entry constructor. You can customize up to 21 colors, tooltip colors not included. In our tutorial, we will change only 14 colors. First, we define our custom colors. Then we set the colors properties one by one. Background of the calendar border and month year name. Foreground of the month year name. The background of day names and week number. The foreground of day names and week numbers. The background and foreground of normal weekdays, the background of selected day, the foreground of selected day, the background and foreground of weekend days, the background and foreground of normal weekdays belonging to the previous next month, the background and foreground of weekend days belonging to previous next month. And here is the result. To create our calendar, we used the date entry widget. But we could have used the calendar widget directly. We import the calendar widget, we comment out our date entry pack statement, we create a new calendar widget and we pack it. And here is how it looks. But it would have been possible to add it as a pop-up using a top-level widget. To know how to create one, how to make it stay on top and add widget to it, check the suggested video. Bye!